India. Allow me to break this down. On Monday, India handed a dossier to the 5 permanent members of the UN Security Council. This dossier was about a major attack which Pakistan had attempted in Kashmir last week. The attack was foiled. The UN Security Council members were provided with a detailed information docket on how the incident transpired. This also included a list of items and munitions that clearly indicated their Pakistani origins. The dossier rattled Islamabad. How exactly did it respond? By submitting its own dossier, a dossier of lies. This happened within 24 hours. On Tuesday, Islamabad gave UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres a dossier which ironically accused India of stoking terrorism in Pakistan. The dossier called upon the international community to take note of what Pakistan calls India's aggressive activities on its soil. The audacity is astounding. The credibility next to zero. India has called out Pakistan's lies. The response by Mr. T.S. Tirumurthy, India's permanent representative at the United Nations, is quite scathing. I'm quoting now, the dossier of lies presented by Pakistan enjoys zero credibility. Concocting documents and peddling false narratives is not new to Pakistan, host to world's largest number of UN proscribed terrorists and entities. Remember Abbottabad, unquote. Person for India's mission to the UN has also denied the charges. I'm quoting again now. Pakistan can cry horse from the rooftops, but they cannot change the fact that they are the epicenter of terrorism. Their lies have no takers. Meanwhile, back in Islamabad, the Pakistan government has decided to form a new national intel body to coordinate all the spy agencies under the ISI chief. This will include both military and civilian intelligence agencies. There are at least 20 of them. They will all now be under one umbrella, headed by the chief of the ISI. What does this decision mean? That the Pakistan military is increasing its control over key institutions in the country. The decision is said to be the brainchild of Lieutenant General Faiz Hamid, the head of the ISI. He is said to be a close aide of Pakistan Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa. He was, in fact, handpicked by General Bajwa to be his voice at the ISI. And he will now control all the spy agencies within Pakistan. Whatever little civilian control was left in Pakistan's rogue institutions is now set to erode.
Remember Abbottabad. India after Pakistan presents dossier of lies at UN. India's permanent representative to UN, Ambassador T.S. Tirumurthy, criticized Pakistan on Wednesday for presenting a dossier of lies against India at the UN. He tweeted, "Concocting documents and peddling false narratives is not new to Pakistan. Remember Abbottabad? Al-Qaeda founder Osama bin Laden was killed by US forces in Abbottabad in 2011, despite Pakistan denying his presence in the country."